Hi guys, they say there are two sides to every story. Well, in this story, it's called Triangular Prism. We're looking for the total surface area. There are five sides to this story. Now, we're looking for the total entire surface area, as I said earlier, of this particular triangular prism across here. Now, here it is in 3D, and we're looking for that. And if we got a bulldozer and we flattened it out and we opened it up, we'd get something like this. We'd notice that we have five sides. We'd have the two triangles, the front face and the back face, and then the three panels that envelope and wrap around it. So let's go back to the original drawing here in 3D across here. Now we're going to do this in two parts. This is part one. Part one, we are going to work out the area of the front face of this triangular prism and the back face of this triangular prism. So there's two faces there we're about to work out. And then in part two, we're going to come back and we are going to work out the entire total complete area, surface area of this triangular prism. But first, let's go back to part one and work out the area of this front and back face. Now, in order to do this, is a bit of a trick and a twist. We have to work out what the vertical height is right there. And we're not given the vertical height, we're given only the side or the slant heights. So remember, in order to work out the area of a triangle, we need to have that vertical height. Remember the formula? Area of a triangle is half times base times vertical height. We don't have the vertical height here. So let's work that out. Let's get the vertical height. That's part one, step one. And then in step two, we are going to work out the area. So let's do that. Let's work out the height first. And we're going to need a particular theorem to work out that height. But first, let me just draw a little picture of what that's going to look like. So here's our triangle. And we have two sides on each part of the slant heights. And they're both exactly the same. And they're both 7 centimeters. 7 there and 7 there. Now the base across the bottom, as you can see there, is an 8. Okay, that's our front face, which is the same as the back face of this triangular prism. Now, as you can see, we have those two lines there and two red lines there indicating it's isosceles, meaning the two slant heights are the same. So there's our triangle. What do we need to do? Well, let's chop it in half so we can get this vertical height right there. That's what we're after, that height. Now, we're going to need to use what theorem to do that? Let me just draw it again. We are given, we don't know the height. We got that slant height, 7 across there. And because the base is 8 and we chopped it in half, half of 8 is 4. So that'll be 4 centimeters across the base of that right angle triangle. Yes, it is a right angle triangle. Now we can actually work out that height using which theorem? Pythagoras's theorem, and I'm going to do it very briefly and quickly here so we can actually work that height out. If you're not sure about Pythagoras's theorem, go back to that chapter, revise it, then come back and you can do this with more confidence. So let's work this out now. So the height squared equals the hypotenuse squared minus the bottom length squared. So that's going to be 7 squared minus 4 squared. There's our hypotenuse. And there's our base there, 4. There's the 4 there, there's the hypotenuse. Let's subtract them. So the height squared is 7 squared is 49. Take away 4 squared, which is 16. That means 4 squared, 49 squared minus 16 equals 33. So the height squared is 33. Let's square root that so we can get the actual height. That height right there is what we're after, so we can get that area. And that height is the square root of 33 is 5.74 to 2 decimal places. Okay, let me just write it up here again. That's our vertical height. Now we can work out quite confidently the total area of that front face. So the area of a triangle is a half times base times height. Let me write that up. That's our formula. Let's just substitute the values now. We have that height, which is good news. The base, we have it because across there is 8. So let's work out that front face area. And that base is 8 times the height, we've worked it out as 5.74. Let's put that in our calculator. 1/2 times 8 times 5.74 for the front face. All of that brown area right there gives us a total of 5.74. That concludes part 1. Stay tuned for part 2. We are going to work out the complete, total, and entire surface area of this triangular prism. So stay tuned, we'll be right back.
Take a minute to check out our website at http://www.vividmaths.com. You'll find additional resources, cheat sheets, transcripts, and other maths videos that are not available on YouTube. Lastly, don't forget to subscribe to get access to all the written answers for your maths questions, plus other special offers.